2015, excellent planting season. A lot of the corn crops were emerged into the 2, 3, 4 leaf stage. And then we had a frost on May 22nd, May 23rd, a very significant one for much of Ontario. So many growers are concerned. Many growers have walked their fields and seen quite significant frost damage in their corn and soybeans. Weather Innovations, they have, of course, a number of weather stations across Ontario, a very dense network of weather stations, and so therefore they were able to map the number of hours below 0 degrees Celsius across Ontario between May 22nd and May 23rd. These were the overnight low temperatures recorded on a 15-minute average data set. And so you can see in Midwestern Ontario here, Mid-Central Ontario, which has the highest elevation, -3 in these areas, it recorded the lowest air temperature. So that's the air temperature at screen level, or about 1.5 meters above the soil surface. And then we have some -2 in the London area, Woodstock area, and Goderich along Lake Huron. And then we have -1 just west of London, and then 0 degrees by Chatham. And then in eastern Ontario, we have temperature ranges between -1 and -2. Air temperatures are very important because the lower the air temperature, that means that more warmth needs to come from the soil surface in order to keep that growing point, those plants, healthy. This is the number of hours below 0 degrees Celsius across the province here. So in the London area, we have 5 hours below 0 degrees Celsius, and then of course in central Ontario we had 7 hours below 0 degrees Celsius. The corn and soybeans, the leaves might be fried off, but the true question here is how much damage did the growing points sustain during these cold temperatures? We're at a field near Ridgetown. So Ridgetown did not experience as low of temperatures as other areas of the province, but still, we still have some fields that have shown some level of frost injury. And so this field, as you can see, does have some excellent corn in the background, but in the foreground here, you can see some injury, and this really reflects the differences of the frost versus air temperatures. Because it's been warm and dry, we should see some growth here after 3 or 4 days. And if there's no growth, such as in this plant, we can call it dead. We can do some growing point assessments by digging up the plant. At the 3 or 4 leaf stage, the growing point is still below the soil surface, so that's good for the corn plant. And we can observe the growing point by slicing through the stem. Here's a mesocaudal right here, and this is the first node, and the growing point should be right at the point of my knife right here. And this point should be a fairly white color or hard color if it's water soaked. If it has brown tissue, that growing point has suffered very severe amount of damage. If the soybean plant had frost injury at this stage, probably these leaves would be burnt off like this. And then the main growing point of the plant will be maybe damaged as well and burnt off. And so here the main growing point is removed, and so these axillary buds would start to regrow, and this would essentially form two stem, like a fork in the stem. This field would not require a replant if the soybean experienced healthy axillary buds here, not frosted off. If this plant exhibited frost injury in the cotyledon area, that means that the axillary buds would be dead, and so this plant would be dead as well. Therefore, if the leaves are burnt off during those early stages, that means that the reserves to regrow, if the regrowth is possible, those reserves need to come from the seed. And so the earlier that frost happens, after the plant emerges, there's more reserves left in the seed, and so therefore there's better chance of regrowth. The earlier they are in the stage of development, especially above the soil surface, then they're more susceptible to frost damage. So if the growing point in corn, for instance, is underground, that's very important for corn. And so we are thinking that if that growing point is protected, that means that that corn should have a good chance of survival. But if that growing point freezes below the soil surface, then that means that the plant, it will be dead.